Here's a short video on your valves, particularly oiling them. What you don't want to do is, you see these holes underneath the valves? Don't oil from there. So you're not going to put your oil in this way. These holes are there to let water and to let other, you know, like bits of gunk or whatever might be in your horn, is to let it fall out. It catches that stuff. And that's the kind of stuff that'll make your valve stick. So if you try to oil from the bottom like that, what you're doing is you're just going to flush all that gunk back into your valves, and they're going to stick even worse. The best way to do this is to just take off each slide in question of whichever valve that you need to oil. So let's say my second valve needs some oil. So I'll just pull this off, take my valve oil, and just put a drop or two, it depends, I don't really need much, so I'm not going to put much in there right now, into the valve. Move it up and down a little bit, check it to make sure it's got the oil that it needs, and put the slide back in, and you're all done. It's very quick, it's very easy. You don't have to deal with taking your valve out. Valves can be damaged pretty easily, and if any kind of scratch on them will make it stick, and that's no good. So if you can avoid taking the valve out, that's great. For the third valve, sometimes instead of dealing with the hassle of taking this big slide all the way off, I'll just go ahead and unscrew it, lift it up just a little ways out, and then put the oil on it and put it back in. Now, when you put your valves back in, this is another reason why you should probably just leave them alone if you don't know the instrument that well yet, is that if you put it in here the wrong way, the air is not going to be able to go through the instrument. So if you can see this, I don't know if you can, I'm going to put it up right close to the camera. You see that number 3? So it varies by trumpet, but usually that number faces the mouthpiece. So when I put this in, I'm going to make sure that number is facing the mouthpiece, and then I'm going to give it a little twist until it locks into place. You don't want to do lots of twisting. That will give you some scoring on your valves, and that will also make the valve stick. So you want to be very careful with your valves. If you don't have your valves in the right spot, you won't probably be able to get any air through the horn at all. So it's really important to have those valves in there the right way. And again, the third valve is the closest to the bell. The second valve's in the middle, that's the easy one. The first valve is towards the mouthpiece. So there you go. Good luck.